Okay, in this video, I would like to give you some guidelines for your research progress presentations. So the research progress presentation will be held on May 18th. So you need to use slides and present these in English. And the presentation order will be determined by a random numbers. So I have already used a random number to determine your presentation orders. So I will discuss this later. So please upload your slide before 1 p.m. May 18th. Okay. So to let me can briefly look at your slides. And use the link here. This is a Dropbox link. You can upload your folders. And the format of file name is presentation order plus your student ID and name. So if you got you are first presenter, you put 1 here. And if you're second presenter, you get 2. If you are third or 13th presenter, you put 13 here. Okay. So what's your presentation order? You can use the link here to check it. So this is course website, and you can download the slide for the guideline for the presentation, research presentation, progress presentation, and also check the presentation order. So here is the presentation order. So the first presenter is Han Chen, and it's the first 1 and to the 15. We have 15 students. Okay, so that's the presentation orders. Okay. And this is a 5 minutes presentation. So my suggestion, you don't need to present a lot of information. So you can keep your slide 1 to 5, but you need to discuss all the relevant informations for your research topics. And to control time, the audience can only ask questions after the presentation. And there's the 2 minutes Q&A. So during the presentation, people cannot ask questions. And the contents of your presentation of your slides, you need to discuss your research topics. So briefly introduce your research questions and clearly point out what kind of causal relationship you want to estimate, what's your outcome variable, what's your treatment variable, and discuss the potential empirical strategy you want to use to verify this causal relationship. For example, you want to use difference, regression discontinuity design, double selection method, matching methods, or synthetic control methods. And because you want to use this strategy, what kind of data set you want to use. You also need to briefly discuss the data set you might use. And especially you need to discuss how to measure your outcome variable using your data and the treatment variable. So what's your outcome? What's your treatment variable? And how to estimate, how to measure. Okay, so that's the content. So you don't need to present any results. The result or any estimate you can present in the second presentation, in your final presentation. So in this presentation, you just introduce the research topics, your research question you want to do for your term papers. I think all of you should have some research question can present after the 2 compulsory office hours. So if you still cannot really know what kind of research question you want to do, please email me and we can discuss. We can have extra office hour to discuss your topics. Okay. Okay, and that's for the research progress presentation. And another thing I would like to mention is about your homework too. So the homework 2, I would like to give you more time to finish it because that's also related to your term papers. And I have announced the homework 2 like 2 weeks ago in the in-person class. But here I will just want to extend the deadline for the homework 2. So the deadline now is May 20th, is a Friday. So you just need to submit your homework 2 before Friday. Before 11:59 p.m. Okay, and there's no late submission, so you just need to submit whatever you get. Okay, and this homework actually can help you to practice some useful data commands and also help you to start work on your term paper. So your answer will include the data command you use, and you need to briefly explain the meanings of that command and also your findings. And please upload your answer sheet and log file through this link. And the file name is your student ID and your name, okay? And this, I think you have ever done this before, so please follow your previous rule to do this. Okay. And the first question is about your research question. So this is just let you write down your research questions. And so what's your research questions? So what kind of causal relation you want to estimate? You want to know which variable affect which variable. And what's your treatment variable? What's your outcome variable? You need to briefly discuss this variable. And how to use the potential outcome framework to define. Use the potential outcome framework to define your the causal effect you want to estimate, you are interested in. So this is so that means you Y1, Y0, and you want to the causal effect you want to estimate is for what kind of population, for the treatment group, for the control group, or for some specific subgroup. And the second question is practice the data command. And here is one is about collapse, another is about append and merge. And these three commands actually you will use a lot when you do some data analysis, when you do data management. And I also have the video for this, so you should be able to know the answer or how to do it.
Useful command that can help you to create
collapse, append, merge actually discussed here. So you can just watch it and apply this command to your data set, to your 10 papers. And another question is about visualize data and using the histogram to display the variable you are interested in. So just need to show this variable their histogram graph. And also use the graph to weight to display the relationship of any two variables you are interested in. That's maybe it's your outcome variable and the covariates or treatment variable. And briefly explain your finding. Okay. So you can also watch the video to know how to use this. For example, visualize data. And that's the video. Histogram graph two way. So you can know this command by watch this video and apply this to your own data set, your term paper. And finally, you need to do some preliminary analysis. It's just very rough analysis, like just use regress to know two variables, their relationship. So you don't need to control anything, just regress outcome and treatment and discuss your finding. And this gives you some preliminary correlation and you can discuss. And the second question is, since you don't control any variable, they must have some selection bias or mean variable bias. So you can discuss what kind of mean variable you might have and what's the bias. Okay, using the mean variable bias formula we have discussed in the class. And finally, you can include some relevant covariates and report the coefficient of the treatment variable. And that treatment variable might change. And you also need to discuss why these covariates you control are not the bad control variables. They should be a predetermined variable. So you need to justify whether they are good control or bad control variables. Okay, so that's all for the research progress presentation and the homework too. So if you have any questions, just email me and we can discuss. Okay, thank you.